Feast of Dominic Savio. The beginning of the new school year is an opportunity to ask God's blessing on our school community in the coming year, and again to remind pupils, staff and parents of the identity and mission of the school. As we celebrate the Feast of St. Dominic Savio, we welcome Father Glenford Lowe and newly appointed teaching and non-teaching staff to the family of our institution. Dominic Savio was born on 2nd April 1842 in Italy. Dominic was an ordinary boy with an extraordinary love for God. In 1854, at the age of 12, he joined the Oratory of St. Francis de Sales, run by Don Bosco. He spent much of his time in prayer and in his desire to become a saint, performed various physical penances. At the Oratory, Dominic spent a lot of time with his friends, encouraging them in their devotions. He formed the Immaculate Conception Sodality. Dominic Savio passed away on 9th March 1857 at the tender age of 15. Dominic Savio was truly a remarkable young man, one who left a mark on the world far beyond his young age. He was small in size, but a towering giant in spirit. His short but beautiful life teaches us that no matter how old we are, we can serve the Lord in small ways every day. In this Eucharist, we will ask for a stronger faith and the grace to be able to counteract the evil that exists around us by doing as much good as we can.
Kindly rise for the entrance hymn.
Sing to the mountain, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your heart. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice. He has turned all death to life. Sing of the glory of God. Sing to the mountain, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice.
As we are celebrating the feast of St. Dominic Savio, today we will pray for all our school children and the youngsters, right from the junior KG to the college and also the NOIS. For all the children, we are praying for their intentions so that Dominic Savio may bless them. We are also offering this Eucharist for all our teachers and for all the non-teaching staff and the support staff, for their intentions and for their well-being. And we are offering this Eucharist also for the new school building which is coming up, so that the blessings of Dominic Savio may reign with us. We are also offering this Eucharist for all the management team, all the fathers, so that God may bless through the intercession of Saint Dominic Savio. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, to prepare ourselves to celebrate this Eucharist, let us call to mind our sins. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Join us in the Gloria.
Yeah.
Let us pray. O God, the source of everything that is good, in Saint Dominic Savio, you have given to young people a wonderful example of charity and purity. Grant that we too may grow as your children in joy and love, till we attain the full stature of Christ. He is God and lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Thessalonians. We appeal to you, brothers and sisters, to respect those who labor among you and have charge of you in the Lord and admonish you. Esteem them very highly in love because of their work. Be at peace among yourselves, and we urge you to admonish the idlers, encourage the faint-hearted, help the weak, and be patient with all of them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly join us in the responsorial psalm. Rise for the gospel.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
For reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After this, Jesus went to the other side of the Sea of Galilee and also called the Sea of Tiberias. A large crowd kept following him because they saw the signs that he was doing for the sick. Jesus went up the mountain and sat down there with his disciples. Now the Passover, the festival of the Jews, was near. When he looked up and saw a large crowd coming towards him, Jesus said to Philip, "Where are we to buy for these people to eat?" He said this to test him, for he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 6 months' wages would not buy enough bread for each of them to get a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, but what are they among so many people?" Jesus said, "Make the people sit down." Now there was a great deal of grass in the place, so they sat down, about 5,000 in all. Then Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to those who were seated, and also the fish, as much as they wanted. When they were satisfied, he told his disciples, "Gather up the fragments left over, so that nothing may be lost." So they gathered them up, and from the fragments of the 5 barley loaves left by those who had eaten, they filled 12 baskets. When the people saw the sign that he had done, they began to say, "This is indeed the prophet who is to come into the world." When Jesus realized that they were about to come and take him by force to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain by himself. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear children, my dear teachers, my dear non-teaching staff, and also all who are listening to me, my dear friends in Christ Jesus. As we celebrate the feast of Dominic Savio, let me tell you one thing, that the system of Don Bosco produces saints. The end result of coming into a Don Bosco Institute and passing away from Don Bosco Institute makes one saints. This is what is the goal of the institution of Don Bosco. And right enough, there are so many saints with our Institute of Don Bosco. Many, many saints, many blessed, and many servants of God. It's an army of saints we are having. And today we are celebrating the feast of such one very, very young saint, Saint Dominic Savio. 14 years of age when he passed away. Yet he reached the heights of sanctity. When he was at the age of 7, he received First Holy Communion. Just to mention, the resolutions which he made were very mature and very demanding, and he kept them to the last. "I will go to confession frequently and receive communion as many times as my confessor allows me. Second, I want to sanctify Sundays and feast days and make them holy. Third, my friends shall be Jesus and Mary. Fourth one, very demanding, death rather than sin." Then when at the age of 12, for the first time he meets Don Bosco, and Don Bosco admits him into the oratory at Waldocco, Turin. He asked Don Bosco to help him to become holy, gentle, happy and serene. Then he said that, "You use me as you want. I will be a cloth in your hands. You tailor me and make a saint of me." And this is what was his wish. He always was doing his duties very well. He studied well. He was always assisting his companions. He was teaching those who did not know. He was helping the sick. And he was always there whenever people fought. He was there to stop that fight. Once he went with the crucifix between two youngsters and he resolved their fight. When there was some material which was adult material being circulated, he went and took the book and tore all those pieces. He was a very strong boy. Gentle, kind, but strong. Strong-willed. And once all the boys who came there, one of the young fellows who came to the oratory, Dominic Savio, very joyfully, very naturally, he said, "Here we make holiness consist in being cheerful." And cheerfulness is a quality of Don Bosco and also of Dominic Savio and all those who go. In fact, my dear boys and girls, I suppose you love to be cheerful. You love to smile. And these are the things which come up when you pray to God. Dominic Savio was very faithful to the program of his life. What was his program? He was sustained by an intense, very deep sacramental life. In fact, some days Don Bosco saw him missing and he knew where Dominic Savio would be. He would be in the church near the Blessed Sacrament and praying lost to the world, present to God in ecstasy. He had filial devotion to Mary, cheerfulness in his self-sacrifice, gifted by God with talents and charisms. This is what Dominic Savio was faithful to the program of life, which he made resolutions at the age of 7. He maintained right through in his life. Don Bosco has a system. In his educational system, there is something called exercise for a happy death. Once a month, Don Bosco is to gather the whole oratory boys. Regularly they pray, every day they pray. Once a month a special talk is given. And apart from that, the boy goes and he tries to make confession. Then he puts order in the desk, in the cupboard which he has. He makes his room clean, his place clean. They clean up the whole oratory. And then whomever they had fought with, they make up, they say sorry. And the whole evening they pray. And with that prayer, that is called exercise for a happy death. They prepare themselves for death. Supposing God calls them today, they are ready. This is what they do once in a month. And that helped Dominic Savio also to maintain his way of life. Today's reading, I take you to the gospel, feeding of the 5,000 men by Jesus Christ, men and women by Jesus Christ. That small boy, he had 5 loaves and 2 fish. That was his. If he has shared with others, he would not get to eat. That's the only thing he had. Maybe it was his tiffin box, which he was carrying. And Jesus, they said, Jesus wants it. And he gave willingly to Jesus, without even thinking, spontaneity. He gave it and Jesus worked the miracle. Everyone was happy. My dear children, Dominic Savio was ready to give his life totally to God, totally to Jesus. And he gave himself in the hands of Don Bosco so that Don Bosco would guide him. That's where is the key. Don Bosco led him to become a saint. This boy also trusted in the Lord and he gave whatever he had. There was another example in the New Testament of that widow's mite. She had only 2 paises and she puts it into that box. And Jesus says, she has put in the most amount of money. All she had, she put. Her 2 paise is equivalent to all the rich people who had put. They put out of their abundance. She gave whatever she had to the Lord. This boy gave whatever he had to the Lord and trusted. My dear children, today as we celebrate the feast of Don Bosco, Dominic Savio, Let us pray to him. Let us pray that we get all his qualities within us. Simple qualities. If today Dominic Savio was there, what would he do? If you are going to be the saints of today and tomorrow, what you will do? You will simply be very cheerful in all the works you do. You will speak good language. You will always pray. You would have a prayer life. You would help the needy. You will reach out to those people who nobody reaches out. This is what Dominic Savio was doing. In fact, he took Don Bosco one day. He went to Don Bosco and said, "Don Bosco, come with me. There is somebody sick." And he took him. He took him to the lanes and valleys of Turin, and there where he found one lady sick. Another time he found one man sick. And Dominic Savio did not go to those places. In prayer, he saw those people and he took Don Bosco there and he worked. The miracle was worked. They were saved. Today, thousands of people are praying to Dominic Savio. Let us pray to him so that he may bless us. He may bless us so that we will become saints. Come, join in and smile. Come, join in and be cheerful. Come, join in and be doing your duties well, both at home and for the studies. Come, join in and pray so that we all become saints. Don Bosco promises us that my system of education, my system which Jesus has given it to me, will lead you to become saints. I wish you a very happy feast, and I wish you many Dominic Savios in our school, both boys and girls, smiling, cheerful and happy. Let us also say together with Dominic Savio, here in our school, we are very happy and cheerful, and we all become saints by becoming cheerful. God bless all of you. Please stand for the prayer of the faithful. Through the intercession of Saint Dominic Savio, we humbly bring our needs to our God, the Heavenly Father, who is faithful and does not abandon us, and who always hears the cry of the poor and the afflicted. Your response will be,
Lord, hear our prayer. Kindly repeat,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people who have suffered due to the pandemic, may God comfort them in their sufferings. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world leaders, that God may give them the grace to work together during this pandemic to promote justice and special care towards the poor and vulnerable. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all essential workers, that God may protect their health as they continually put themselves at risk in service of others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our management, teaching and non-teaching staff, that they may work together, bonding to build a strong community and a vibrant institution. May they always rejoice in their fellowship and be united in your truth and love and be true witnesses of Christ by showing their love for others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our students, that God may shower his choicest blessings upon them to help them to acquire knowledge and wisdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We now pray in silence for our local and community needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of compassion, help us never to doubt your power in drawing good from evil, even in a tragedy like this. We ask this to Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Kindly join us in the offertory hymn.
Pray that yours and my sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May the sacrifice of salvation that we offer you, Father, produce in us the order of your Spirit, which enlivened the heart of Saint Dominic Savio. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. In the festive assembly of your saints, you make the young Dominic Savio abiding light, docile to the action of your spirit. He was able to travel in a short space of time, a sure and simple way to holiness, in joy of heart and faithful fulfillment of his daily duties. In the company of the angels and saints, we raise our humble voices in a hymn of praise as we proclaim your glory. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint John Bosco, Saint Dominic Savio, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Anima Christi, soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. water from Christ's side, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within thy wounds, hide me. Suffer me not to be separated from thee. From the malicious enemy, defend me. In the hour of my death, call me and bid me come unto thee, that I may praise thee with thy saints and with thy angels forever and ever. Amen.
Kindly join us in the communion hymn.
Are you tired of chasing pretty rainbows? Are you tired of spinning round and round? Wrap up all the shattered dreams of your life, and at the feet of Jesus, lay them down. The dreams, wounded hearts, broken doors.
Give them all,
give them all to Jesus, and He will turn your sorrows into joy. And He will turn your sorrows into joy, and He will turn your sorrows into joy.
Thanksgiving prayer. Mighty God, thank you that you know us and you love us. The ability to teach is a gift from you. Help us to use the teaching gift you have given us effectively. May we be filled with your Spirit to give us the enthusiasm, strength, and love we need to carry out our role. Give us assurance that you are always with us. May God the Father prepare our journey, Jesus the Son guide our footsteps, and the Holy Spirit watch over us on every path that we follow. Amen.
We have had a wonderful Eucharistic celebration, inaugural Eucharistic celebration, also commemorating the feast of Saint Dominic Savio. And we have invoked God's blessings on our new academic year. Let's continue to pray through the intercession of Saint Dominic Savio. Pray for ourselves and for our families, that God may continue to protect us and keep us safe, and pray that the lockdown may be lifted at the earliest and we may be back to school soon. I take this opportunity to thank in a very special way our main celebrant, Reverend Father Solomon Rapola, Rector, for having presided over the Eucharistic celebration and also for having given us a very inspiring message in the homily. And he has given us a kind of a motto for our school, that our school should be known by its cheerfulness and also by its dedication, the dedication of the students towards the task at hand, imitating this little giant, Saint Dominic Savio. I also thank our school management team who have celebrated
this Eucharistic celebration. I thank Father J.S.U. Robinson, our administrator, our newly appointed assistant parish priest, Father Glenford Lowe, and I thank Father Reynold as well. A special word of thanks to Father Reynold for having made all the arrangements for this Mass. I thank Sir Savio for the Mass animation, and I thank the teachers who are present here for the Eucharist and for having helped out in the animation as well. A special word of thanks to the choir, Pranali, Ian, Marilyn and Karen for uplifting our worship with their melodious voices. A special word of thanks to Olaf for rendering his technical support right from recording to rendering to also uploading the entire celebration. Thank you, Olaf. And I thank Sudhir, our sacristan as well. Thank you and God bless you and wish you all a happy feast of Saint Dominic Savio.
Let us pray. May our sharing in this Eucharist help us, Father, to overcome sin as we follow the example of Saint Dominic Savio. Strengthen in us the commitment to lead our brothers and sisters to a life of joyful service in your friendship. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bow down and pray for God's blessings. At the end of each invocation, your response will be Amen. May God our Father, who brought us together to celebrate the feast of Saint Dominic Savio, grant you the abundance of his grace, and let you savor the fullness of his love. Your response?
Amen.
May Christ Jesus, who freed us from sin by his death on the cross, give you the courage to seek his friendship above all else. Your response?
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit, who made Dominic Savio a tireless apostle among his companions, make you joyful proclaimers of his love. Your response?
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Wish you all a very happy feast of Saint Dominic Savio.
Prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants, and in controlling the spread of the pandemic. We pray that the vaccine be available for all our people, even the poor and those in rural areas. We pray for doctors, nurses, and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Kindly join us in the recessional hymn.